All right, folks, want to call the August 31st Redistricting Committee meeting to order. Our first order of business is approve the minutes from last month. Did everybody receive the minutes? I need an approval on those.
Make a motion to approve.
Motion to approve. Do I hear a second? Second. Questions or discussion on the motion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All that oppose? All right. Mike has got a few things. According to our timeline, we were going to try to look at the top seven districts and start working on those. There's been a couple of little tweaks that we need to take care of, and I think Mike is going to, if you'll pull up that plan issues part, Mike, and kind of look at a few things here that we have. The first thing I do want to do, though, last week we pulled up the map that that Mike had done, and we looked at that, and we need to approve that as a committee level, as it being our first initial map, so we can go to work on that, and then this will be like map one. And then once we do our tweaks and stuff tonight that we're going to do to it, then that will be map number two. And so we'll just, or version number two. So we'll go each week or after we do revisions of that, and then we can post it also on our website and let folks that's looking at it be able to look at it, and as well as ourselves to continue on the look and tweaking for each meeting, okay? So if you would, if somebody would make a motion to
move,
and do I hear a second?
Second.
To approve this map as our number one version.
Number one.
Any questions or discussion on that?
I just want to make sure that everybody understands it's clear that this is not,
absolutely,
that we're making changes to it.
Absolutely. This is just the first map to give us something to work off of, and they've done that. Now we're getting, and as soon as we approve it, we're getting ready to start working on it. So it's going to change tonight. We don't know. Any other questions? Discussions? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All that oppose? All right. We have got that one in. And Mike, you got some large scale issues. You got some fine tuning issues. And personally, let's do some fine tuning first if we can.
All right.
And then we might have some, spend some more time on the large scale type issues, but what can we do in the fine tuning part to kind of?
Well, one thing that we can really take care of real quick is something that a member of the committee, Joe Frank Jurgen, pointed out to us this week, is that along the border between districts 4 and 6, along John Bragg Highway, to preserve communities of interest, there was some blocks that were following, or a boundary that was following the power line instead of the road. And if once we follow the road, it would keep the people within the area that they traditionally have been in.
Can you flip over that map?
Yes,
show
sir,
us what you're talking
about. Yes, sir. Let me move over and zoom into it for you.
Okay. And folks, y'all, committee members, y'all got a thought to zoom across you. Just jump out there trying to be recognized, and we'll move on that way. Okay.
It is the area between Coleman Road and I believe it's
Murray Kipper
Road. Yes, sir. And as you see, there are several that are 0, and then there's a 9 and a 1 and a 2. There's like 12 different people in this area, and we would move them from this power line dividing line up to the John Bragg Highway. And to do this, it's relatively easy. Is we would pull from District 4 and put it in District 6, and we would then select these blocks like this. And if you look over at our statistics over here, we're taking 12 people from 4 and putting 12 people into 6. and it is not changing our deviation significantly. They're still both within that 5% guideline.
And Mike, the reason it was that way is, I mean, the power lines, the TDA lines,
yes, sir,
that you can, we can officially go off of, and that was one there where it was just a minute little change, and that's,
yes,
what we're, that's what we're looking at. So
that, and that's what you're here to look at and try to balance out. Now we can commit this just like that, and it's done.
I was looking at that map. I seen that, because you used to come there. If you didn't, you leave the end of three roads, just a little bitty section there. And the rest of the people on them with three roads is in a six. And I feel like at Main John Bragg Highway, all the other districts up down it separates it there instead of using a power line.
Mr. Chairman, I'd move that we make this change to map number one.
Okay. We have a motion to move this as a change. And number one, a second. Any question or discussion on that?
I have a question.
Yes.
Why would you stop and not continue where the 31 is? I'm not familiar with that area geographically, so I'm not sure.
You'd be moving 31 people there. Right? I wish you would go on, but that'd be moving 31 back in the day.
I can show you statistically what would happen if we do this.
There's a road right there, too, isn't there?
Yeah, there's a road right here, Weeks Road, yeah. And there's another road right here, and one through here.
So then it's going off the boundary of Weeks.
This is following roads. But if we move these people from 4 into 6, we select these here, we look at our statistics, 6 goes over by 5%, and 4 goes under 5%.
So
that is why those people are in the 4th district instead of the 6th, is to balance it.
Quick question. Over into my district, he goes over the highway into my district, and there's a spot that was one of the large changes. Could we take a few of those people to put him back over and then fix, who is that? What, the purple district?
That's 4.
4 on the other side?
Which district is yours?
I'm 8.
Sorry. 8? We can look at it.
Because I think that was going to be an issue. A large-scale issue. I think that was one of your large-scale.
We can look at it. That's what we're
Before we for. Jump into that, we've got a motion and a second on this. Any other questions on this motion or discussion?
So without these two changes, right?
Right.
They could be added later.
Absolutely. Yeah, it might need to tweak back the other way once we, you know, you pull something over here, it might turn the scale on the other side.
You're talking about on your end over there. Mm-hmm.
Any other questions or discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? All right. We have our first initial change to our map that we just approved. Okay. Do you want to jump up with that, Mike, and see what she's talking about then, since you've got a question there?
Over that side of
right there.
Well, if you pull that many out of Roberts is one you'll have to look. I mean, he would lose.
Yeah. We're going to explore.
I think it's the north, above 269.
Okay.
Yeah. Right up there.
In this area here?
The part that's
already
to the left.
That's already
right
in 6.
Here? You talk about this area?
North. Go north.
Up here?
Yes.
Yeah, further up.
This area right in here?
That's already in 6. We're trying to take out of 8 and put into 6.
Go further up the map.
You're talking about in this area?
Yes.
You want to put all this in 6?
Well, I don't know. What are the numbers on those?
Well, let's zoom in and see.
It is going to be a lot.
Yeah,
there's a lot of people.
You got 292 in that room.
Okay.
There is a significant number of people in this area.
You'd have to have
them.
Yeah. You'd need
to. So pretty good. 5% of it right
here.
I was just trying to find a way to give him some more and, you know, shift a little bit so that we could put that into 6, that area into 6.
Well, actually, what you need to do is you need to give more to 4 and take some from 6.
So if you took some from down this area.
Oh, I understand.
If you took that many out.
Currently, 4 and 6 are two extremes.
Okay. I understand, sorry.
Okay. Mike, in our timeline, we're going to take the top 7 and work on those tonight. sticking with that, we can jump right in and start doing that. Or the large scale issues, do we want to kind of do the seven, and then we'll deal with those large scale issues as we roll into it?
Mr. Chairman, when we came up with the initial plan of working on the statistically top seven, when we looked at the gross adjustment plan that we did here, we took care of a lot of that.
Right, right.
And have balanced all these districts as they exist right now in the plus or minus 5% population. So that has been done. My recommendation is to start in a geographic area where you see that there might be some problems and try to knock them out first.
Okay.
Like maybe in the northwest section of the county here, like we've shown with the necks on 5 and the neck on 12.
Well, and that's in our top 7, 1, 5, 10, 11, yeah. 12, 9, 3. So that's what we're talking about right there.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, let's do that then. That's sticking with our timeline and moving forward. So let's start with District 1 right there.
Okay.
And folks, if y'all have got any notes on this, that y'all have looked at it this week, or as we pull up District 1 right here, got a suggestion on tweaking this right here. Right now, he can pull up and show right as he's got under it what we've got, what we're looking at in total numbers, and we're within the percentile there. So, and District 1 is here.
Yeah, well, you know, I obviously can see a lot of things, but I don't know, you know, if you show the whole map, just a thought to get rid of, not just one, but where 5 and 12 come, yeah, okay? Well, where 12 is, it's wildlife management area, the airport, you know, that part of it, so it's nothing.
Right.
But you got the neck up there getting down on the left side where District 5 comes in.
At 468 or
yes,
on the
yes.
Side. Okay.
And I'm saying, and then you got over on the green, where the green, dark brown, and light brown come together.
Mm-hmm.
That area in there, that can, to me, can be squared off because there's roads, because Fergus is a big road coming in, and it's, and that can go back to one, whereas you can take some down at the other end and put that into 5, and then down below, where Murfreesboro Road is you can take, they'll go straight up a little. No, the other way.
This way?
Move it up.
Like this?
Okay, yeah, now you can see C-12. See, it's on the other side there, but you can then move in and give along Murfreesboro Road, you know, go by your blocks, go along Murfreesboro Road and give that back to 12. Mm-hmm. And that way you're getting, I guess, compactness instead of your points going.
Okay, so what you're saying is take some of this area and give it to 12.
No.
And take some of this area and give it to 5?
No. Yeah. Some of that area and give it to 1, which is the green.
That's right here.
Yes. Then down where the 468 is, and that green going along Stones River Road there.
This right here?
Yeah, something in there, give that to 5.
Okay.
And then down at Murfreesboro Road, give some of 5 back to 12.
Let's look at just the 1 stuff for right now.
Okay.
Then. All right, so what you're saying is you want this area in here to be 1?
Yeah.
How There's far down?
There is a dry creek bed going.
Right through here?
Yes. I'd say, can I go up and pull
it? Yes, sir. Feel free.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Stand on a chair, why not? But I'm set, right here is Fergus Road.
Uh-huh.
It's a main road going on out. That continues there, and it turns into Bill Stewart. It's only one road.
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying, come down Fergus to the dry creek bed.
Which is right here.
That's it? Okay.
Yeah, right here.
Just that side of the road.
Uh-huh.
You can cut it off, whatever that number is. Then start giving some of this down here to 12, because they go right, it goes right on the other side. So, and it can cut in and give square this up, because you get this big point, you know, coming down. That's one thing you were talking about on those large scale.
But this, and I'd like to point out, this is following two major roads that in the area.
Uh-huh.
So,
but then you got all this up,
and then
up in here, that wherever your blocks go or your roads go, that can go back, and it's still right here with 5.
My question, man, that's about 1,200 or 1,500 people
right
there, pretty
quick.
It's populated all over.
Yeah. The only way to find out is to looked at it.
But like we said, we're more compact now than we were 10 years ago, correct? With the, what we have grown up.
Bless you.
If we look at, we've got 2.81% in one, and five is 0.95%. So we've got some numbers we can move around and not significantly affect our statistics.
And what's 12 have?
Minus 2.1. So again, it has also got a lot of room too. So we can look at five into one in this area here. That's the area you're interested in, correct?
It's 500 people.
It takes five. Yeah, it's 517 people. Mm-hmm. It's going to take five to minus 3.18 and one up to almost seven. But we're going to take some of one and put it back in five.
Correct.
So we can look at this here, run that, and then come back over here and take some from one and put it in five.
Wow, he's tweaking the computer right there. We've got in our minutes from the first meeting, second meeting of our
talking about like that.
Our attorney, Mr. Coop.
It's almost
that right there.
Excuse me, folks. While he's tweaking that, right now we've got Mr. Cope here, and we can turn him loose if we ain't got no major questions for him. It's got in our minutes that for him to be here, and personally, I don't think, unless we're in some kind of questionable state for our attorney, we need to have him here.
I think he needs to stay the attorney.
And as you notice, Jeff said that. Okay.
He said he was going to pay you out of his pocket.
Do we have any questions for the attorney tonight? Mr. Cope, we certainly appreciate you being here. And I will make sure before this meeting's over tonight that if we need you the next one, we'll ask for you to be here. We'd love for you to be here, but
thank you.
You might have some other things you need to do.
Well, I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks, sir. I'm sorry. Y'all go ahead. I just didn't want to have him here if we didn't need him here.
After the adjustments here, there is really no significant change in the deviation by changing these numbers. So as such, they could go either way. You know, either way could be, would work.
Laser.
Between one and five.
One concern that I have is that a neighborhood that we cut into?
Right in here?
Yes.
There's a dry creek bed that separates two different subdivisions there.
Okay. I just didn't want to split up a subdivision.
Yeah.
It's Heritage Valley East.
Okay. This area
Heritage
right
Valley
here.
West on the other side.
This area right here is a dry creek bed or a wet creek, depending on whether it's raining or not.
Yes. Very wet when it rains.
So you're still looking at trying to take this out or no?
Straight down
Fergus Road?
We took this area right here and put it in one.
Okay.
And it was within 18 people of being this area here of what we put into five.
And so your boundary then is a dry creek?
We've got a dry creek bed, Fergus Road, Sandhill Road, Hollandale Road. I don't know what this one is. And I'm not sure what this one is or this one, but this is Stones River Road. And then I imagine this is a water feature right here. So some kind going down to
Hurricane Creek. And those 10 houses got to be way back down.
They're going to be down here,
I guess.
Yeah.
Or 10 feet. And that keeps it compact. But to me, you had 5 and 12 then, and you got room on down here that with the light brown and dark brown that you could put together. That you could maybe,
that
except you got your
button at the top, yeah.
I'm just saying that in through there, you maybe could do something, but you do have the two major roads cutting across there with Jefferson Pike, so that you may want to point left.
Part of the problem is we have the railroad running through here, and there are no streets crossing through this area. So if you start messing with this area, you're gonna take a huge chunk right through here, which is 500 people. There's probably about 1,500 people in this area right here. plus this area, and this area is another 500 or so.
Okay.
Doug, weren't you wanting to do something with that 422 down on 12, or you decided no?
Yeah, that's what I was looking at. Mike pointed out that that's the old Nashville Highway and Jefferson Pike. They come to a intersection with a light right there, so it's a great dividing point. It's, that's why. It, because he was talking earlier about the, well, it was on the large scale problems or whatever. Mm-hmm. About, you know, it's like a spear sticking into District 5 from District 12. So
yeah, this neck right here is what we're talking about.
Oh, okay.
It's a narrowing, but there's Sam Ridley Parkway and Jefferson Pike going into it. There's two major thoroughfares for that area, mm-hmm, that are going into that area. Again, what we're looking at is the 1 and 5 here for 1 and making sure 1 is at a satisfactory point. Now, if you draw a line right through here, almost a straight line, this is almost following a straight line, so that would follow some of the rules of compactness, because it is, well, I mean, it does look okay. Remember, when it comes to redistricting, you know, appearances do matter, and this looks okay. And actually, I see one little thing here that you might want to look at. Actually, not part of that block. It's in the river anyway, so.
Right. This little deck that we had a brown sticking into the green is now common. So
that is correct.
Makes
correct.
That a lot better.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you're all right with number one, even though we might tweak it again.
Yeah.
Mr. Chairman, I have a question.
Yes, sir.
Do we have to make a motion on each change? For instance, that's two changes. I just want to know what the to each district.
We can do that and kind of like set it to the side, or we can wait until we get through with all the changes tonight and approve those changes as map number or the number two revision.
Yes, number two, revision number two.
Well, we just did one.
We may forget what the
that's
change
right.
is as we
should,
go along.
I
yeah.
think we should vote as we go along.
Okay, Mr. Chairman, we could, when somebody has an objection on something, we can stop right there and do it that way.
Yeah, that way
they wouldn't forget.
Let's take them out as we go then. And then
well, I'm ready to second the motion that you're fixed to make, hopefully, Commissioner Schaefer.
Okay. Well, I'll make a motion we approve the changes between 1 and 5.
Okay.
Thank you. And I think
we have a motion and a second. Any other questions or discussion on the motion?
With me on that.
Your discussion?
I just say that I believe that the District 5 commissioner and I have talked about things, and believe it or not, she said she put her trust in me, but anyhow.
Okay.
But it helps us both on travel.
Okay.
Which is what it does.
Any other questions or discussion?
Yeah.
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All that oppose. All right. Good deal. We knocked out one. Mike, you want to jump into 5?
Let me save this real quick, please.
All right. Yeah, please save that.
So we make another change to one, will we have to go back and amend what we just did, or just
it'll be another change.
Okay.
Yeah.
We're kind of thinking of this as 1.2 that we just approved.
Okay.
Right. And then at the end of the meeting, we can approve our overall, what we've done, and then that will change it to map number 2 or version 2 for everybody to see and for us to look at for next week, and then we'll move on, maybe do 7 more. Our goal is try to get through 7. If we can get through more than that, that's great. But 5, we're ready for 5?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And you said you and 5 have talked.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but
and was there any other tweaking there that we need to do on 5 or that right there? What did it do on those numbers, Mike? I didn't look at that when you
haven't run the numbers on this, but we can take and put this into 12 right here and try taking this area here and put it in 5 and see what happens, if y'all wish.
Okay. I mean, I'm just saying, you know, if it's not this version right here of 5, then you change it to knock out this last block. It looks like to me it's going to throw it over, but I don't know.
what we can look at, again, we looked at 5 and 12 here. 5 is 0.81, and 12 is minus 2.1. 0.21, excuse me. And if we take and look at this area here, it's 362 people, and we commit that to 12, like this, and come down here and commit this area to 5. All the odd things that are in here. That's 492 people. It's going to make them well within the 5%. Y'all, did you want to go further?
What is the purpose of changing those? Because you still going to have a...
You still got all this area right in here that's going to be separated. I don't know what this boundary is.
It's a street.
The residential street?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Just looking at it, the change is more confusing than it was before.
Yeah,
I mean, I don't care, but I'm just
breaking up the neighborhood.
The way it was looks better because it's two major thoroughfares.
And it comes out at the traffic light.
Yeah. Now, you can still, if we look at 12 and 5 as they are right now, 5 is minus 2.09, and 12 is plus 2.69. You can leave this change as this or put it back.
I believe I'd leave them like you are.
Either way will work.
Mike, how many people live in this section, this west section of 12, the little arm
that jets
up? Yeah. How many people are we talking about there?
Just a second, I'll tell you.
Because you've got the bulk of 12 on the other side
over
of the street.
Over 2,000.
More than 2,000, I'd say.
There's 2,500 people there. Or excuse me, 2,800.
And is that where the commissioner lives too?
No, that is where a
school board member lives there.
No, a school board.
Yeah, school board member.
Yeah.
I don't remember my college.
That's a red dot. Sorry.
Yeah. But that is a school board member for 1, 5, and 12. I would call.
I think you can put 5 back the way it was.
Yeah.
All right.
Back the way it was.
Any thoughts on 5 there? Anything else we want them to tweak on it?
How many people live? You said 5 is under, right? 5 is undersized?
5 zero. Is just barely over.
Yeah. Okay, let me see the map again.
Probably the closest of.
What about that lower triangle? See where the main looks like Old National Highway. How many people live in that area?
If you were to
square
here?
No, see in the brown side that's in 12.
The brown.
Oh, right
if
here.
If you were to move that, no, look, go right
that's
here.
Area
that triangle.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's look.
I'm just trying to square it up a little bit. I've just never been happy with that jetting out from 12. When you talk about communities of interest, I mean, that's not a consistent here.
Yeah, that's
781.
781 people. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. That puts 5 over and 12 under your statistical limits. But you could theoretically give this to 5 and then come up here and take some of this area and put it in 12. And somewhat balance it.
Can we see that?
Yeah, we can look at it.
Well, before you change, Mike. Right up here. I like this. Yeah. But we could get this area right down here going across. Isn't that a road that goes the whole way through?
That's that dry creek bed right here.
Okay. And it comes out on Murfreesboro Road too. Well, no, that, you know, you do that.
Creates another point.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
It's going to get closer on population.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you got 515 in that block, so you can't.
Yeah, well, again, this area right here is only bisected by the railroad. It's not bisected by any streets. So, as such, this big, huge block right here is all one big chunk, and it's hard to come up with a compact district when you've got the geography working against you, which is what we have here. And again, that's something that can't be held against you because that's what you've been given as to start from. So do we still want to see this, see what this does?
I'd like to see it, please.
Okay. Puts us within the 5%. If you look right here, you got 5 is plus 4.16, 12 is minus 3.56.
What does it really accomplish? To me, it just looks like it's a similar design. It just, instead of it being a point there, it's a rounded circle.
Yeah. I was just trying to keep more of the commissioners' districts together because it just seemed like for a little bit they meander. And that's what I was thinking in terms of just trying to square them off a little bit. Can you zoom out so we can get a better perspective of what it looks like as a whole? If you look at that compared to the original map we started with, and it's that CC4 in the back of our book, to me it looks a little more compact. But Mike, you're kind of the expert here. I mean, you tell me what it looks like to you.
This, either one was acceptable. But also, I'd also like to point out, this is not CC4.
Okay.
This is something different. This is what was posted on the website.
Okay. But CC4 is a close version to it. I mean,
CC4 was, yeah, very close because it was based on some of the same principles.
Yeah.
My one concern about doing this is we've got the variation so much larger now. And when you look at growth, you know, we might have some districts later on that are going to be.
Well, your responsibility right now is to get the balance as required right now.
Sure.
It's not to look at future growth. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But the little section we just put from 5 to 12 up there, mm-hmm. right there, that the only way in is that Fergus Road up Murfreesboro Road, because you can't, there's nothing going from the airport. That's all airport to the east of it. Mm-hmm. So there's no roads that go through.
So that's not a positive change for you?
This doesn't concern me. I mean, I'm saying for the District 12 person, they got to go down Murfreesboro Road further to get over there to the right before they get to Fergus, because they've already passed Jefferson Pike.
Got it.
This area right here is more associated with the Laverne area than it is the Smyrna area, is what he's trying to say.
Let's change it back then.
So you need to leave it in 5.
Change it back.
Yeah.
Oh, do we want to put this other triangle back in 12 then?
Yeah.
To balance the population?
Yeah, I guess you'll have to.
Okay, we now have 0.94 and minus 3.4, or 0.34. I think I missed a little block.
Yeah, let me.
Because the numbers aren't quite exactly what they were. Yeah, there's 17 people here. Let me grab them real quick.
Good. Do you feel like the number?
It's all about the numbers.
We're all just numbers. Yeah.
If this is Cheney Road right down through here, so it's another major road that it was following.
Looks compact.
I'll make a motion that we, the way we have District 5 right now, we leave it that way.
All right.
I'll second.
We got a motion and a second on 5 and leaving its tweaks right there. Any questions or discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All that oppose? All right. We got 1 in 5 done. Let's look at 10. And I just, not in any way, form, or fashion, but the top 7, 1, 5, 10, 11, 12, 9, and 3, right? That's this area. So I just got 10 right here. We could go, we should have probably did 3 before we did 5. But anyway, here we go. Let's do 10.
I'd like to point out some geography of 10 before we really start on it. Some things that you have note is...
Okay.
Is you have a school board member here that has to be an 8, 9, or 10. So the commission district right here, mm-hmm. 8, 9, or 10.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry about this. I'm going to make this as small as it's easier for me to move out of the way. And that's here. And then the county commissioner lives here.
Mm-hmm.
And you have a large amount of population here that used to be in 5. And it had to go somewhere. And the commissioner for 9 lived way down here. And we tried to convince him to move, but he wouldn't.
Across the intersection, so it's always been 10 headed.
Yeah, it has. This has historically been 10 through here.
Yeah.
You do have Sam Ridley Parkway and River Rock Boulevard, not River Rock, Rock Springs Road moving down through here. So you have two major roads connecting these two sections. I feel confident that we could defend this if we had to. But its appearances do matter. If you try to adjust some of these areas here, you do not have any major roads moving through this area until you get down into here or up into this area here, which cuts off 10. So that's what you've got to look at and think about.
Sounds like, Mike, in your professional opinion, that 10 is serving the best purpose right now that it could serve without just completely rebuilding 9 and 10. Is that right? And then maybe affecting another? I mean,
we may have to do that.
Right. But with the major access through the neck there between 24 and Sam Ridley and Rock Springs, then that gives access, commissioner, whoever, to that area. So it makes that neck, it kind of explains that neck and as to why it's there rather than it just being some kind of gerrymandering or something like that. Right. You said it easily to defend it, right?
Yes, sir. I believe we could.
Okay.
Can you zoom in a little bit so I can see some road names?
Yes, ma'am. What particular part of it?
Just really right there around the interstate.
Right here?
Yeah.
Yeah. Blair Road here, Sam Ridley Parkway here, and Rock Springs Road running down here. This is the hospital right here.
Let's put Blair. You take it out.
The gray is proposed roads, correct?
Yes, sir. Those are roads that are either currently under construction or proposed on a plat of some kind.
That's Rock Springs, right?
Yes, sir.
Can you go west and north so I can see what part of Laverne that picks up?
Basically, the area from I-24 south.
Mm-hmm. To the county line, yeah. Mm-hmm.
As far as the city of Laverne is concerned.
On the 24.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And then can I see the opposite side of the interstate? Still in 10. I want to see 10 on the
other. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
You mean down here?
Yeah.
It's going on that way.
Keep go south a little more. Yeah. What's the road there that splits? I've got where the number 11 is. What's that?
Right in here?
Yeah.
Wildwood Drive.
Okay.
It runs between Rocky Fork mm-hmm. and Amable Road.
Yeah.
And then go south again.
Of course, that's where they live too.
Where is Amable Road? Is that
the old Amable Road is right here?
Yeah.
Right there.
Yeah. Okay.
I make a motion that we keep 10 as it is.
We have a motion to keep 10 like it is. Do I hear a second?
A second.
And a second. Any questions or discussion? What was the numbers on it again, Mike? They were pretty close, weren't they? 10.
Minus 1.29.
Yeah, but you know, 9, 10, and 11 are all really pretty close.
Yeah.
All of the districts that were presented in this initial in 1.0 are all plus or minus 5%.
Yeah. Okay, motion and a second. Questions or discussion? Keeping 10. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All that oppose? All right. Moving to 11. We got a boot on out there, but.
Bottom of Texas.
Yeah, got it.
Yeah.
Texas version 11.
11, there. You have some areas here. We initially started with 11. Being just this area right here, which is historically where it's been.
Mm-hmm.
We needed more population and 10 needed less. So we pulled into 10 in this area here and this area here, and then I forget what this used to be, but it became 19 now.
Ron, have you had a chance to look at that?
I'm trying to figure out the street name. What, right where your cursor is, what's that road? Is it 1 mile lane?
Right, no, if this area, this road right here, mm-hmm. it's not showing up to be identified. Stewart Valley.
Okay. Yeah, it makes sense to me. I knew it needed to grow to the west. It makes sense to me the way it's drawn.
Stewart Valley runs all the way down.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it runs all the way down here, but they've got, it runs down to Baker, excuse me, and then Baker comes down.
This is one of the districts here that I looked at. You know, if you look at the big picture on it, it does look, it don't look compact. Mm-hmm. It looks sprawled out. And like you said, if you followed Old Nashville Highway, yes, you know that. But then when you got Texas out there and you got the southern part right there, mm-hmm. it don't look compact.
You know, as far as defending this, you've got Rocky Fork Road,
mm-hmm.
Wildwood Drive,
mm-hmm.
Old Amable Road, down to the interstate, down to Baker Road, and up Stewart Valley Drive back down back to Old Nashville Highway.
Right.
You are following major roads in the area, if not arterial but collector status roads.
Yeah, I was hoping we were going to be able to square it off, but you can't do that without killing 10 because of where people live.
And you have a problem here.
Yeah.
But there are roads that go through 10 that where you could square it off to keep 11, you know.
Yeah.
So does that mean you're good with 11, Rob?
I'm good.
You good?
Again, I think I made this point last time. I'll say it different this time. Again, what appearances do matter. But how much do they matter to each individual person is entirely to me.
Yeah.
I'm kind of in agreement with our chairman. I mean, looks like to me that's, but on the other hand, if we can defend it by major roads and if it works, I'm okay with it.
Let me see the clicker 1 second. I just have a question.
Looks like that on paper, but if you follow the main road, it ain't.
Mike, is there any reason why you wouldn't have just kept squaring this off instead of picking up over here. Although, I mean, these communities do run, this community runs east to west, so from community interest, that makes sense.
Yeah.
But from compactness, I was just curious why you wouldn't have picked up there.
I think we needed some population for three.
Okay.
Is why we did that.
You're going to have some heavy numbers right underneath your 41 sign. Right, yeah, right there. You're going to have some heavy numbers right there.
Three comes all the way over in that.
Yeah. But that's going
to
be...
I mean, like I said, that community does run east to west, so it makes sense for our community to be that way.
I remember 10 years ago, we had to come over there to get enough for three.
And this is Chicken Pike right here. And mm-hmm. again, as we all know that live in that area, that's a fairly major road also.
Oh, yeah.
Well, as far as the west side and the south side on 11, the parts that sort of appear to jut out, it's not like anybody lives in those areas that we're trying to draw the lines out to grab those people or trying to draw the lines to draw somebody out. So
yeah,
I don't have a problem with that. You know, like you said, that community going east to west and so on.
Well, I hate to be so quick, but Ms. Allen, if you got a motion for
us. I make a motion we keep 11 as presented.
Second.
We got a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All that opposed? All right. 11 is tweaked. And how about 12?
We've laid the northwest corner there to death, didn't we? A while ago. So.
Yeah, we've discussed this area. This area here is the center line of the river, so mm-hmm. it is acceptable as compactness, even though it mm-hmm. doesn't look compact. You've got Jefferson Pike here, and you've got Sam Ridley Parkway slash Nissan Boulevard.
Why don't you show us the numbers there along the river, so zoom in on that. So that's what I figured. Nobody.
Yeah.
Well, it looks pretty good.
And to look at the numbers for
12. Trying to think, who's the commissioner over in 12?
Yeah.
Steve.
Minus 2.1. Excuse me, 0.21. I keep moving the decimal point.
Robert's usually here. Is he not here tonight?
So he's right at zero, isn't he?
Yes, sir.
He's our most optimal man. He's the closest one. One of the closer ones we got to being perfect.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll make a motion we keep 12.
Okay.
Second.
Motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? Like I say, if they come back and need, you know, a little tweaking, we can always do that. We're trying to get through the main part.
I believe 12 was at minus 9% or something earlier. But at the beginning, I mean, when we first.
Before?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Almost
got it. No questions or discussion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All that oppose? All right. District 9, another portion of God's country.
The whole county's that way, isn't it?
That's true. I said another portion.
a little explanation of the boundaries here. You've got Rock Springs Road, or not Rock Springs,
Rocky Ford?
Yeah. Rocky Ford.
Rocky Ford. Sorry, there are so many rocky roads in this county. Walden Road, and I think that's Lake Road. And down here, Independent Hill Road, it's a creek, excuse me, that's what that is. This is a creek right here. Hamill Road, East and West Overall Creek Road. Stewart Creek Road. The Burnt Knob Road. Manson Pike to 840 to 24 and back to where we started from.
Well, the only two things that I see that I would like to try to is this area right here. There's not just a few, but and keep Burnt Knob straight, because this isn't really a road. I mean, it is a road, but it's not a finished road, so to speak. It's a
Yeah, you got to travel down the creek to connect the two roads.
Yeah. That's what I wanted to say. So,
a bunch of people in
I there. Would like to see, like I said,
we want to see the numbers?
We can come back and adjust, yeah, but this right here,
mm-hmm.
why wouldn't we go to Independence Road, Independence Hill Road?
No reason why we couldn't.
There's only 18.
Yeah, right. wasn't many, and I think that kind of gets that line back. But the only major part I have is right there, and it's not the location or the people, it's just squaring that up and then actually to a road or to a...
This right here is going to change 18 people.
Yeah.
It's making 20 minus 0, minus 0.02.
Almost perfect.
Almost perfect there.
2/10 from perfect.
And puts 9 over by 3.02.
2/100 from perfect.
Now, if we look at this area here, I'm going to zoom in closer so I can control the selection process better.
Unless we take some out somewhere else.
Gonna put him over.
See if we.
Yeah, I'm just going to show you what it's going to do here. It's going to put 9 over by almost 10%, and 20 under by almost 6.68%.
Well,
can we take some out of 9 up the northern?
What's the?
Because 10 was 10 was.
Under. What's the other road coming through here? Isn't there something else right in here?
There's just the creek.
That's just a subdivision road then, isn't it? Okay.
Yeah, this is the creek running through here.
It's just.
And this is the two different subdivisions, one here and one here.
Yeah.
Wasn't 10 under? Does 10 have some room to grow at the north?
Let's take a look. That's a good idea. 10 is under by 1.29.
Yeah, we take some off the top and put it in 10.
Yeah, we got to be careful if we take it away from 20.
Well, we can look at it.
Yeah.
I'm sure we can keep shifting around.
What's the number we're looking at? How many?
Ooh, there's 10. Brad.
Mm-hmm. Brad Turner.
Oh, we just got what approved at 10 a while ago.
Yeah. Hold on. Let me figure out how many is here real quick so we get a number. 833 people.
Wow. There's more in that new subdivision there than I thought.
If we look at this area right here, and just follow Rock Springs Road all the way out. Let's see what this does. That's 1,000 people, or 1,100 people.
1,165, yeah.
And that puts 10 over by a significant amount.
Yeah,
sure does. That's one for it, Rich.
That would be a logical place to make an adjustment. Anything else through here, you don't have any major east-west roads until you get down here, the Lee Road.
So 10 is over.
What's this?
Do you have
right in here, what if we, what is, I'm trying to think what that is right in here.
That's all those hillside subdivisions that Smyrna's developed off of Rock Springs Road.
Well, I'm just trying to draw a line. I don't know how many numbers there are. I'm just
being close to the same.
This is, I believe this is the current Smyrna city limits through here. And this is a creek, I believe.
I think we have the same number.
5, 4, 9.
This is all one block, by the way. That's one block.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And if you try to put the rest of these guys in here. Make things even.
Hey, I don't mind kicking it in four-wheel drive, going across the creek and seeing those other folks. I don't mind doing that at all. Just, you know.
That's, again, another 1,300 people.
I'm just trying to square it up there.
Well, is there somewhere that we can take from...
Well, we can't do it there, so...
10... And put somewhere else?
If you take 10, you're going to be going the other way.
Let's see the big picture again there, Mike.
But if we added those to 10 and then take some off of 10 in another way.
You're going back. You can approve it, too.
I didn't give it to 20.
But an approval doesn't mean we're never going to look back at it.
Makes sense.
What do you think there, Mr. Chairman? You're the expert on that area.
I'm pretty easy going. I just, well,
What you're saying, Mason.
My two-cent opinion was it sure be nice just draw a line right there and keep it all on burnt knob and, you know, keep it in different nine, you know. But then I have too many people.
Yeah, if it's any consolation, sir, when we initially drew this, we did have the line all the way across there for you initially, mm-hmm. and then when we started working on 20, we realized we needed more population for them, and that's where we grabbed them from, to balance out the population, which is the first priority.
I say,
you want about 9, 10, 20 is going to be short.
I just don't want to tell them, you know, hey, I just threw you out of my district, you know. I love you. Well, maybe we come back and...
What's at the bottom end?
If something happens and we tweak some more later or something, maybe something pop up, but if not, hey, I'm okay.
So we could maybe gain from 7 to give to 20. If that little neck doesn't put 9 over too much.
Let's stay on task. Let's vote on 9.
You want to
we can always come back.
Chairman,
I make a motion that we approve 9.
Second.
Even though the chairman, I'm sorry, I can't make the motion.
I'll make the motion for the chairman that we approve.
Thanks.
I'll second.
Motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All that oppose? Thank you. All right, let's go to number 3.
Three takes a meandering route following the center of the lake. Down Jefferson Pike, down Nissan Boulevard, down Chicken Pike, Old National Highway. One of the side streets here that separates one of these two subdivisions in this area, I forget the name of it. Down the railroad tracks to Broad Street, down 840, over to Shacklett Road, across Allen Road, I believe.
Which way he is now.
And then up Leanna Road, Swamp Leanna Road, follow the river for a ways, up Jefferson Pike, Mona Road, Allen Barrett Road. I see one thing right here. We need to probably move these guys into 3. Did y'all see this right here?
Mm-hmm.
This is separated by the river here, but they're all within that same subdivision. That subdivision crosses through here. And maybe even follow J.T. Todd Road over here like this. You know, it's 23.
I was going to say, probably
it's 100 people difference between 2 and 3. That's not going to be a significant change for them.
Let's do that.
Again, just as a recommendation from staff.
Let's do that. Taking them out right there, putting them back. And that's keeping your roads.
That opens it up a little more, too.
Yeah.
It squares it all off.
This goes here to Old Lebanon Road, right through here. I forgot to put the numbers, sorry.
Well, can that part over there to Lebanon Road?
All the way to 231.
Yeah, why can't it go to there?
There's, 16? 24
that.
More people?
24?
Well, before you do that right there.
18 and, yeah.
Talking about those two right there, the 24 people?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
That's going to make us, both of them, less than 1% deviation either direction. So
look at that.
Hopefully, what are you talking about? 2 and 3. Is that what he's talking about?
That's all.
3 is a rather large area.
Mike, how many? Zoom in right where the 41 is, where 3 jets across.
Right here.
Yeah, that little pocket right there. How many folks live in that area? What are 19's numbers? Could 19 handle?
Not 1,000.
No.
There's some numbers there I need to put in.
Actually, it might be able to handle it.
Can we look at that? Can we try to move it and
it'll
see what it
is? It'll put 3 significantly under, though.
Well,
3's
If you take 1,000...
It just seemed like an odd pocket.
If you take 1,000 out of 3, it'll put it roughly 10% under.
What are 2's numbers? I'm just wondering if it could pick up any of those from 2.
It's already under.
Yeah.
2 is already under.
Can't get none off 4, because 4 is going to be hurting when you do.
Scroll down to 14. What are 14's numbers? They're under 2. Guess you got to leave it.
I'm sorry?
I said, I guess you got to leave it.
Yeah. Again, we had 3 pretty much locked in following here, and we needed more people. That's where we went to pull them from.
It is spread out.
Compactness is the theory.
Well, I mean, if it's sparsely populated.
30 on our list of priorities.
Yeah.
Remember that.
Mike, will you zoom in one more second? I thought I saw a stray... Go south, scan south. Yeah, keep zooming, right there in the very center. Yeah, see that little pocket that's in 3, but looks like it belongs in 19? What is that?
I'm sorry, I'm not.
Right,
oh, they got the pointer.
Right here.
Yeah.
Oh, that is thanks to the Census Bureau following CSX railroad tracks.
Okay.
The Census Bureau says the CSX railroad tracks come down here and make a hard right-hand turn. And then make another hard left-hand turn.
No wonder we got so many crashes there.
Road and then doing a funky thing there and then coming back out. So,
we need to get that fixed before we have any derailment.
That's a blocked line.
Okay.
By the Census Bureau that's not quite right. And the reason why we did that is this block right here,
mm-hmm.
That one right there,
mm-hmm.
See how long and skinny it is?
Right.
Is we had that originally in 19,
right.
Even though it's only 4 people, but it stuck up into 3 and it looked really odd, much more odd than this little notch looks here.
Okay.
So it actually goes to the railroad track then?
Yeah, this is actually railroad tracks.
This is 19.
That is correct.
Okay. Any more comments on 3?
Good eye.
Move to approve 3.
Move second. To approve 3 and second. Any questions or discussion on it? All
that's
those
with the changes in the north
with the
east
changes.
Corner.
Yeah.
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All that oppose. All right. We have got the top 7 adjusted. We've just been an hour into it. Do y'all want to push on?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Let's push on. We'll jump into the next 7.
Let me export those changes.
Okay. Do those changes, and then you tell me where you want to go from there, really, because we'll just... as we've kind of worked north, northern end, northern west end, we'll...
It's on 11 while you're gone.
Mike, where do you want to go to?
Let me look at it just a second, sir. I'll get some water.
All right. And we've done 1, 5, 10, 11, 12, 9, and 3. And if we drop down below that and kind of get the... Yeah, let's get the wide view right there and see.
You got several choices. You can either go on the rural areas, or you can start digging into the Murfreesboro area.
We might need to dig into the Murfreesboro first, and then expand to the rural.
Dig in,
It don't matter.
Either way will work statistically.
Start us off then, Mike. Where you want to go?
Let's go to 19 since it's next to 9-3.
All right.
Since we've already looked at some of it.
19.
With 19, we have Stewart's Creek or Stewart Valley Road and Baker Road, I-24, all the way down to Little Tennessee Medical Center Parkway, which goes all the way over to Broad Street up to Thompson, Thompson to Sulphur Springs to Shacklett, 840, and then Broad Street down to this. Longview Road, and Old Nashville Highway.
One of the different. Numbers?
Where's
I'm sorry?
The?
What are the numbers on?
On 19.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, the commissioner's barely in the district there.
They're almost.
Almost at the
max in the under, so they could take some more population from somewhere if you want to give them.
You could take it from 16.
Looking at some of the districts that are adjacent. It's 15, 16, 20, and 14. 14 through 16 and 20. 14 is under, 15 is under, 16 is over,
16.
And 20 is right, almost right on the money. So the only one you can pull stuff really from is 16. Unless you pull from multiple districts over. You can go someplace else and move some of them to one district, then hop to the next district and pull some there, and then do it again.
We'll move down there where we can get a little bit better look at 16.
We can pull them from 9, too. But, yeah.
Down in this area, you're not going to find many population because of it's all of it's commercialized.
Mm-hmm.
We chose Medical Center Parkway just because of it's a major thoroughfare through that area.
Mm-hmm.
No population either side.
Mm-hmm. You can check the corner right there.
What about to the right there on...
This area
yeah,
here.
Right, all that area down in there.
Yeah, this is separated by the railroad tracks down through here and College Street, Old Nashville Highway, and this is Thompson Lane here.
We'll check corner up in yon.
What, this one?
Yeah.
That goes with 16.
Yeah.
There's 153, 234, some big numbers right there.
Yeah, you've got a lot of people across the road here. That's all one neighborhood, yeah.
Actually, doesn't Medical Center Parkway come down through there?
It comes down to here, yeah.
Okay.
This is, what is this?
Right in there. Right in there. Yeah.
That's the river, actually, right there.
Yeah.
That's following the river to college, and then...
would it make sense to take that from Medical Center Parkway up to 41?
I'm sorry, go where?
Take that corner.
Take all this?
It's not that many people.
What's...
Move up there what corner is. Move on
up Hamilton Drive?
Right in there. Where?
It's too many people.
Is that 153 right down there? Or is that
right here?
Yes.
Yeah, you got to pull all this in here. And that would make a...
Well, that's a block right there.
Yeah.
That would make more points than you got.
I like what Commissioner Jones said about taking Medical Center down and get you to the Broad Street, that area there, that gets some few more in it.
That makes it 29, 33 people. That's not a significant amount. I mean, and it can take it, and it would even it out and make it more.
And it's on the road versus the river, right?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. We can do that.
Let's change that then and see what we got.
Yeah, it's 33 people, and it's going to knock 16 down a little bit, and knock 19 down a little bit the other way. So they're both. It's a positive move for both of them.
That's a.
You want to commit to that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, let's see what looks. Sure looks like.
It looks better.
It does look better, doesn't it?
Something appearances right do there. Matter.
I mean, that's a four-lane road right there.
Yeah.
And if I was the commissioner, I wouldn't want to have to turn off of. That into
just floating down the river anyway.
Yeah, what I'm saying.
What's your numbers? What do you need?
Statistically, we're good. We're minus, we're just real close to the edge, but we are in other ones also, so it's not the worst ones at the edge. We've already been through those.
What would you say?
Actually, 4 and 6 are the worst. We haven't been through those. Excuse me.
It's within, ain't it?
Yeah.
18. That's Josh, ain't it?
Mm-hmm.
I move to approve.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Second. Questions or discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All that oppose? Okay. 19 has been tweaked. Mike, which one do you want to jump in next?
Catch up on my notes.
Okay. You want to save that too?
Yeah, I already have. Thank you.
And
have we done 16 yet?
16.
We reviewed it a lot. That's why I just thought I was just mentioning it. We talked a lot about different parts of it. But
we haven't done 14, 15 yet.
16 is right. I would go to either 20 or 16.
All right, let's go to 16.
There's a lot we can do with that. Though.
Can you defend that shape, Mike, just real quick for us?
You've got, it is bounded by two very major thoroughfares.
Right.
Medical Center Parkway, Old Fort Parkway, Franklin Road, and then Broad Street, Northfield Boulevard, Sulphur Springs Road, Broad Street, or no, excuse me, Memorial, Clark, a little bit into this neighborhood here, because we need to get some people to 15, Tennessee Boulevard, Main Street, around the square, down Church Street, back down Broad, back to Old Fort Parkway. This area here is following Puckett Creek, or Overall Creek, it's Puckett Creek, excuse me, to what was Fortress Boulevard before all the roads have changed, and down to Manson Pike, and then back to Medical Center. Those are all very significant boundaries, except for this area right here where we needed to pull some population into 15.
How close is 16?
I'm sorry?
How close is it on the number?
On the numbers? It's over by 3.74%. That's why we pulled some from it to go into 15, because 15 needed some extra numbers and pulled it down.
I was going to say instead of that, well, yeah, it's going the other way if we do that, mm-hmm. though. Like, if you took this area, we're going to be looking at 20 here in just a second. Mm-hmm. Took that down 24 to kind of line it up. But that's taking the numbers the other way, though. Yeah,
20, wasn't it 20 that we was looking at taking?
2 100s and being perfect.
Wasn't it 20 that was affected by yours, that one change that we wanted to make in yours?
Yeah.
There's a corner where 16 goes to 15. That's, is there a better way to take something from 16 over there? Is there there's some roads coming down. They don't look like major ones, though, but they go from that little neck where the 96 goes up by 15.
Wait a minute, he's looking.
I'm sorry, my chart got a little messed up here. I'm trying to adjust it back to where it needs to be. You were saying where?
What did this do right here, though, first? That's
a highly populated area.
Yes, sir.
It's complete over or under, whichever one we do.
The only thing I don't like about it, we're not following a major road there. This is a creek.
So the major road.
The reason you're not is because of this number right there.
Yeah.
And it would narrow this down significantly where we had to pull some from.
Yeah, that's a
big number. 7 and 13.
Ain't no doubt that's a big number.
Well, skin looks kind of like we...
What are we trying to do? I'm sorry, Jim. Excuse me.
I'm sorry. I was just thinking our hands are tied. Jeff, we've got good boundaries, and the numbers make sense, and we can defend it, and compactness is third down our list, and first is to be within 5% of below, and that looks like 16's got it, so... before I make the motion to, that we keep it the way it is, Jeff.
Well, I was just looking at that Blaze Drive right there. Go back where you were.
Sorry, sir.
The area to the left of Blaze Drive where the 16 is all the way to the highway, that area down there, reason I say that, two reasons. Not a significant number, so we'll just bring it down.
Yeah, we'll bring it down.
And secondly, it's a road. It's yep. not a creek. Oh, I have no objection to either.
That's true. That's true.
You're talking about taking all this and putting
yes,
it
sir.
To
yes, just staying
on the west side of Blaze.
Where's the high school?
Okay, staying with Blaze Drive.
Take a look at that?
Yeah.
300. And if I'm not mistaken, yep. those are two separate neighborhoods, so we're not splitting up a neighborhood that way either.
And that gives 20 more and knocks 16 down.
It's all part of Blackman Farms, what we got there on both sides of Blaze there, but it's got the elementary school up the top part of it, right?
Right here, the elementary school.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And where's the high school?
The high school is back over here to the left.
Okay.
So it does not divide the schools.
That's what
the schools are all together, all one district. The high school's here, the middle yeah. school's here, and the elementary school is here.
That's a good point.
The middle's here, actually. High school.
Well, what we do to 16? Do we help?
Hey, that's
true. We brought 16
down.
This would bring 16 down to less than 2%.
More manageable number, maybe.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. It moves 20 up.
It brings 20 up.
But it's still a decent number, though, right?
But it follows
yeah.
the road.
Yeah, it's a reasonable number, yes, sir.
And
that's
if we follow the road, it makes more
road.
Sense.
Yeah. Could that do anything with that stick out in 9 that we talked about earlier? Or was mm-hmm. it too hefty?
Let's go ahead and make that change, all right, Jeff?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I'll make that motion.
Yeah.
Yes, we make
well,
that change.
That's all right. Let's just go ahead and make the change. We'll make the motion.
I got to
right.
figure out what's going on down here with this.
Oh. That needs to be
perfect.
The railroad has jumped again.
Another right-hand
jumped
turn.
The track.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Right-hand turn.
Mike, when you get to stop and point, I have a question.
Okay. I just want to make sure we've got what's all that? Of our little bits and pieces here. Because this little bit here is. Okay, I see what's going on. This was drawn before the road was completed by this, for the Census Bureau. So
okay.
they drew the blocks where they drew them. That's why it's got that little point there.
Does it have, I mean, can it come up to Blaze Drive instead of?
This is following Blaze Drive, except that little point right there.
Oh, take
yeah.
out those two.
But that's because
blocks,
the block could cover
blocks.
This area.
Well, I'm
here.
Just saying, we're here, make, you know, I mean, it's, we need to correct it, right?
No, it's nothing
oh,
we can do about it. The block
we can
be
change.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. What if we take out those two just zeros? We need to take out those. Yeah, right.
I'll put these into here.
Mm-hmm. Just make it look a
yeah,
little
bit. Yeah, that would be perfectly acceptable.
Yeah, that would make it look better.
It sure would.
Mm-hmm. Just go take your
phone.
Mm-hmm. And that's not going to change anything.
Mm-hmm.
Just made it.
Other than make it look
better.
Neater.
Good
yeah.
job.
Yeah.
Solved the problem with the census.
Well done, Tiffany.
Everybody like that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Smarter since you got
yeah. I've got a big enough ego. I don't need a stroke. Do you?
Look here.
What else we got right there, folks?
Where's the cord?
When you get to where you can, Mike.
Oh, yeah, she was on.
Yeah, will you zoom out? I want to look at 12 and 13, kind of the south there.
All right, I'm going to save this first.
Okay.
That's
yeah.
right?
Yeah. yeah.
And since we might be doing other changes, I'm going to call it 1.5.1. Which way do you want to go?
Okay, when I was looking at the chart just a second ago, and I'm pretty sure 20 is under and 13 is under.
20 is now over.
Okay.
We just added to it.
And 13.
It's just 2.20 is 2.3.
Right there, less than 1%.
Okay, let me see the map again. It might have been 16 I was looking at. It's just barely over.
You want to see 16 or 16?
I held my question too long. I think I forgot what I was, because I was looking at if there was some way, I was thinking between 20 and 13, I was looking to see if there was some way to shave some in each direction, it seemed like. I was thinking there was, I think it was this little pocket. Could 13 pick this up, and could 20 pick this, or I guess it'd be 13 too. Mm-hmm. I said my question too long. I was being polite too long. I should have made it. All right, it'll come to me. We keep looking at them.
All right, 16. Any other tweaks or discussion or looks? We need to pull up anything else on 16? Like I said, looks can be deceiving there on that thing, but in compactness, what'd you say is third down on
that?
Third
down. Right there at 18 where the corner goes into 16. Is that on a major road, the corner of 18 is into 16 up right there?
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I want to zoom into that and show you what it looks like. This is based off the historical boundaries that have been in that area.
Okay.
We did not change any of these from where they have been. I believe I'm correct, right, Mr. McAdoo?
Yes.
What does the numbers on 18 look like? Can we take some out of 16 and put there in 18 to make that a little more?
16.
18 is under. And 16 is over by a little bit.
What do you think, Commissioner McAdoo?
Ain't no people in that area.
No.
Them zeros.
Yep, you're right. Should have looked before I spoke.
I mean, you could very easily square this off without any significant change.
If you move it over, can you move the map over to the right? No, the left. To the right. Okay.
Yeah, 14 there on West Main Street. Those apartments upstairs, but, you know, there's...
I was just trying to think of a way to make that look a little better.
Well, you'd follow South Manny, wouldn't you? You'd go all the way down South Manny and take mm-hmm. that whole little...
Mm-hmm.
Let's see here.
No, you can't.
No,
never mind.
You'd be going west on Castle.
Well, no, that's a school board member.
That's a road board member.
Road board member, I mean. So they would still be representing the three districts, I would think.
They're 17, 18, and 21. So you can't put them in 13 or 16.
Oops. That's why it's there. Mm-hmm. All right.
But you can go over and add some from 16 to 18 to make it a little.
In other words, you just don't really like the way the lines look. It's not that you're actually changing the numbers.
I'm trying to just make right. I'm just trying to make it
well,
look
because
a little.
Because it's a square right there. You can't square it.
Yeah.
Do that right there.
Yes,
you can pick
that
up that
work.
Zero, that triangle or something there, but that's, I guess, Vine Street.
Yeah, that's Vine right there.
Yeah.
That's City Hall is what that is.
Right. I mean, I would put the square and then those two people into 16 just to make it squared off. I mean, it's not that it really makes a big deal, but it just
right.
makes it a little more compact.
Do you want to put it over and see what it looks like?
Mm-hmm.
Mike, can you put it over there and see what it looks
yes,
like
sir.
Then? And Jeff's got the pointer right there if you want to, if you're not bringing out what you... That one. 4 zeros and a 2, or 5 zeros and a 2. Is that what you're talking about?
Yes.
These, right there.
Mm-hmm.
Just that, yeah. Okay.
And that's just a change of 2.
4 zeros and a 2.
That's what it looks like.
Looks good.
That's better.
Those relatives.
Look at that.
Those relatives.
Jeff and Tiffany coming up with those great ideas tonight. All right, y'all happy with that? Not to push you, we're just going to move right on along if y'all are good with 16.
Have we voted on 16?
No.
Oh, we will.
Motion to approve 16.
Motion to approve 16 with the tweak.
Oh, do we? Okay.
All right, we still got a motion. What about with that tweak on there, whoever made it?
Two tweaks, really.
Two tweaks.
Thank you, Jeff.
As amended?
Yes,
right,
I made that motion.
Okay. You like it as it's amended then?
I'm crazy.
I like it as amended.
All right, all right. All those, questions or discussion then about it? Anybody?
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am?
Will you go back to the map and go northeast? Right, see those, right where the 15 is, those little block right there? Why is that trimmed out?
This right here.
Oops.
Not 200 some people.
Oh, I've lost my chart. Excuse me just a second. I'm sorry. 15. Yeah, that's
room 16.
Is there a part? 15.
No.
It's kind of a lot of people.
I think we're getting ready to go to 20 here in just a second, right after.
The numbers are close on all of them. Yeah, when you start cramming them into a small area, it looks like a lot of people.
There it is. If you look at 15,
okay.
It was minus 1.65 and 16 was 1.38. We can try to put those back. I believe that was the reason why we came across like that. Was the balance of, but you are right, that would make it more compact than following regular streets.
250 people.
Let's just try it and see what it does.
Yeah. Doesn't hurt to try.
No, you need to go from 15.
Yeah.
15 to 16.
Oh, 15, sorry.
Yeah, so 15 to 16.
Yeah. It takes some from 15 and puts them into 16. They are both within the parameters of the population specified, and it does make it appear better.
Yeah.
I like that better.
Mm-hmm. I like that.
Include that in my motion, too.
All right. Man, a motion of many tweaks.
Three, specifically.
All right. Looking at 16 with its, give us a wide version there.
Yes, sir.
There we go.
Looks much better.
Get the numbers off there.
Did y'all say it was much more compact? Is that what y'all said?
Much better. Much better.
All right. Any questions or discussion on approving 16? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? All right. 16.
15.
It's been tweaked. Why not 15 while we're there?
I would do 14 first.
Would you?
And then go to 15.
Well, let's jump into 14 then.
14.
Problem with that.
14 follows Ames Drive to Sulphur Springs Road, I believe, down Thompson Lane, Broad Street. Not Thompson Lane, it's Northfield, sorry. Broad Street to Thompson Lane to Sulphur Springs Road, Allen Road,
have a look up, there's your name.
Leanna Road, Swamp Leanna Road, up Central Valley Road, up the river.
Oh, there's a zero we can square.
Yeah. Well, this is following a stream right here, and then this is the river. And then it comes down Jefferson Pike, down 231.
Sorry, Jeff, I didn't want to, you were going to say that word.
Well, there's not a good place to cut it off.
Mm-hmm. Well, that one little finger.
About up here?
No, yes.
That one little finger that sticks over there on the Leanna Swamp.
Talking about this right here?
Yeah.
This, well, what it is this line right here, mm-hmm, is a city limits line. Right. And this street doesn't go all the way through.
Name of the paper, man.
What are the numbers on 14? And three.
Three is 0.55 over. 14 is under by 4.25.
Ooh, they
need, so 14 can take population.
14 needs some people. But it's in line, yeah.
Because I was thinking to cut that top off, but you can't do that.
No. No.
Looking at
incumbency, that district would need people.
You know, and part of this too, we're trying to put the common sense factor into it where, you know, not cutting off a road.
What's this road right here?
Yeah, I was looking at the 289.
But if you look at this school board member here.
Which way is he?
He needs to be in 1, 2, or 3.
Okay.
Barely in 3.
And.
Wow.
He's in 3. So you have to take that into consideration. Yeah, it would be kind of nice to follow this down through here like this. And it would look better.
Well, we said we'd give consideration to incumbency. Are we giving consideration, or are we going to be absolutely?
We have so far.
Yeah.
We haven't had any problem.
Don't know.
That's not a big enough.
Who is that? Who is that school board member?
Grant Kelly.
I hate to draw anybody out.
Yeah.
For that. It's not necessary.
It's not that really.
Yes.
Where's somewhere else that we 14. Might could take?
Does he need numbers?
No, it's in
the
grass.
It doesn't necessarily have
it's within the 5%, but I mean.
If you want to change for just a change, you can, but it's 19, not 16, 15.
2, 15, and 19, and 16 are what's surrounding elsewheres. And 2 is right at, basically right at even.
Mm-hmm. 15 and 16 or?
15 is under, 16 is over. To pull from 16. 19 is already severely under, well, not severely under, but already under.
Approaching your limit.
Yeah, approaching your limits.
Okay.
And if you want to look at some of 15.
That's a lot of people.
16 was
more. Was it 16? I'm sorry.
We're working on where we get 16. We can
say there and try to
balance
a little bit more.
What's the road that goes down where on the number 16 here?
This right here?
Mm-hmm.
That's Jones Boulevard, I believe.
How many people are to the west of that?
On this side?
Mm-hmm.
That's Battleground, sorry.
16 to 14. Unless I'm missing something.
That's 324 people. That does adjust them down to much better numbers on both of them.
Would you not go on down to whatever that, well, I know that you grabbed that 02 or following the roads there?
That's just the mall, but.
Right. Yeah, I mean, that squares it off.
Mm-hmm.
With a road. No,
it actually balances a bit better.
Let's look at the big picture.
With the change?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I'm leaving it in the red so you can see it.
Still looks weird, but.
The numbers balance a little better, I think.
Make a motion to approve 14 as recommended with a change from Nicole down there.
Motion to for 14 change.
Mm-hmm.
Do I hear a second? You've seconded. Questions or discussion on 14 then?
Can we add 16 with it? We just approved it a while ago. You're taking out of it.
Now 16's done with the change. No, we're going to approve overall at the end of the night.
Okay.
So. We're making these tweaks by we're going, and then we're going to approve all the changes together.
Okay.
Any other questions or discussion on 14? All those in favor? Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
Will you go south and let me see the bottom of 16 to see if it makes? I know we've been following Battleground, but I just wanted to see did it make any sense to keep going, but it really doesn't. Okay. I just needed you to zoom out. It's fine.
That's fine.
Any other questions or discussion? On 14. All those in favor signify by saying aye then.
Aye.
All the opposed? Okay, 14 is good.
I would go to either 20 or 15.
Let's do 15 since we're right there. Mr. McAdoo, is this you? No, that's not you.
No,
17. We ain't got to you. All right, 15.
This follows Sulphur Springs Road.
Who is 15?
Haynes Drive, Lebanon Pike,
Adam.
Compton Road to, I forget which, there's one, there's two creeks in here, and I forget the names of them. There's one here, one's Bushnell, and the other one's something else. It's following the creek because these creeks separate these neighborhoods down to the Jarnet.
I see.
And then Pitts Lane, the Northfield to Top Tennessee Boulevard, to Clark, back up Memorial, and then following Sulphur Springs Road back where we started.
And so can you close up that right there then? Let's take a look at that.
Okay.
So it could do this number?
There is real no significant road coming down through here that separates this area. The only thing that really comes through here is this creek.
Okay, so this isn't a road right here.
Let's look. There's a lot of city limits mixed in here and little bits and pieces where the city limits have adjusted.
Oh, English Hill Drive.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I can, give me just a second here. I'll turn off these blocks and leave the streets there.
They've been used to going off the creek boundary line before. Is that
there's the streets as they exist today.
Okay. So go up to the top a little bit with that street thing.
That way?
Yeah, and then widen
the streets back, huh?
And then, yes, sir. And then widen the angle just a little bit, or there we go. A little bit more. There we go. I guess that's something you got to stick with.
Looks like it's pretty much it.
Yeah, those neighborhoods down there are, you can technically cut through, but you have to meander back in and around to do it.
Yeah.
I think that looks good.
Mm-hmm.
Move to approve 15 then. Second.
Motion and a second on 15. Any questions or discussion on 15?
I just want to see the numbers again. What are the numbers on it?
Mike, can you pull up the numbers, please,
sir? 15 is minus
3.68.
That's fine. Any questions or discussion? All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? All right, now let's jump over to 20, right, Mike?
Well, you can continue on to the direction you're going or go back to 20. It doesn't matter which.
Okay, let's go to 17.
17 will be relatively easy, I think.
It looks right.
It's
compact.
If you want to talk about a compact district, 17 is a prime example of it. It follows Tennessee Boulevard.
That is
to Main Street.
You like it.
Brunswick, Northfield. And that's it. The numbers on 17
are perfect.
Are within 1%.
Look at there.
Jeff, too. Perfect.
I'm going to make a motion. We approve 17.
I'm going to enthusiastically second that.
Enthusiastically.
I think Mr. McAdoo beat me.
And we got a third, too. Okay. Any questions or discussion on 17?
That's a no-brainer.
Everything nice and tight all the way around, no loose ends.
Compact.
Do we need to look at it?
No,
we're good. It follows all the streets.
Okay,
follows
all the streets.
I mean, we can look at it closer if you like.
All right, I agree.
A quick tour of it.
I'm just making sure this is our job to tidy up everything. So
it encompasses the MTSU campus.
Okay.
Northfield Boulevard.
Good, nice, clean, cut streets right there. Okay.
Let's not get carried away.
All right.
We're fixing to go to 4.
All right. If there's no more questions or discussion on 17, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Okay.
Okay, you got multiple directions you can go now. 2, 4, 21, or 18.
Let's look at 4.
Let's get 18. Get the city.
Y'all want to finish up the city with 18?
Yeah.
18. Let's finish up the city at 18.
Well, you still got 13 and 7 and 21 that covers city,
let's
too.
Let's do 21 next.
Oh, well, we'll drop down here. Let's get 18 and we'll move on.
All right. 18 follows Main Street, Church Street, to Broad Street, to Middle Tennessee Boulevard. I see one little purple triangle here on Middle Tennessee Boulevard that needs to move, but down to 99 to the Stones River, down 231.
Now they get rid of it.
To
County Farm Road.
This is, I believe this is the city limits line.
Yep.
Follows through here, following the railroad tracks, down to County East Farm County Farm Road. Road, up Elam Road to Joby Jackson Parkway, back to Broad Street, down to Parkview Terrace, down Brainville Pike, South Barrett Lane, the North Barrett Lane, and back to Main Street.
Okay, do they take the all the time?
Tonington Heights.
That's definitely
Drive. Oh, Tonington Drive.
10 years ago, he split.
It doesn't get the last little bit right here.
That's in a block of a 139.
If we look at your numbers, between 21 and 21 is minus 3.9, or 3.5 already. 18 is already, yep. You can move them. It's just gonna. It'll make you closer to zero. It'll make 21 closer to five.
No.
But it could be done.
Probably
go down to Lakeshore, and then I don't know this. I don't know what this is. Is this a power line or something moving through? I think that's a power line.
It is.
Yeah. This is the head of Todd Lake, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That
so it's following this road right here, but it's there's still part of you're saying is
good.
Yeah.
Right
yeah,
here.
Yeah. Gotcha.
I think that would make sense.
It would square it up a little bit.
That and Commissioner Serino is not
where,
driving.
Where's the polling? Yeah, where's the polling place for 21?
I don't think I have them in here.
We're going to let the election commission deal with that.
Yeah, I do. Right here.
21
there's one here, which is
that church out there.
Your church there.
And
one over here.
One at the school, ain't it?
What about the polling place for 18? Yes, polling sir. Places, let's see the polling places for 18. Yeah. I was just trying to think about what makes sense for.
We may have
those are,
to change
those are dead
some
ends.
Of those polling places anyway.
Right. I mean, those are dead ends. That's the only one way out kind of
mm-hmm.
deal.
Fox Camp School.
Talking about right here?
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right there and then the other one below it.
This right here.
Right.
You want to move them from 21 to 18?
Which
well, following the power line?
Let's see what it does.
You mean down this way?
Yeah.
That little?
Sir?
Yeah.
Yeah. This area right in here.
I'm talking about what? I'm talking about
141.
Okay. All the speeds, it just wanted to
move. Yeah,
you
got
some. Yeah. That puts 18 almost to minus 1%. It takes 21 up closer to 5%, but it's still within the parameters.
You might want to zoom out and see.
That doesn't split a subdivision, does it?
There's an older subdivision over here off of Lakeshore Drive. I believe there's some houses through here.
But that's saying, okay, and you're talking about that would be in that 139 census.
Yes,
dollar.
Ma'am.
Okay.
But does it correct your Toddington Heights?
It does.
Mr. McAdoo?
Yeah. I think the first way will correct it. I just hate split streets down the middle.
Yeah.
What's that street name right there then?
That is this power line.
Oh, power line.
It takes all the time to drive and this stuff. won't split those streets up through there.
You said it's 521?
Yeah, no,
18.
There's not really a good answer.
There was something down at the bottom you said you was going to look at. Down the bottom of 18.
Oh, it's zero or something.
It was some kind of little.
Yours is not a real good answer.
Oh, yeah, there was, it was actually over here. Right here. You talking about what I said?
Yeah. No, I thought it was at the bottom of 18. Okay, look at that then, see what that is. That's just squaring it up.
Yeah, that's just a minor adjustment.
There was a little boot or something down at the bottom of 18 that I was talking about.
Are you talking about following the city limits here?
Right there, I think, maybe, or something.
Right here?
Yeah.
That's, again, following, in this case, following the city limits, it did this. We could very easily put all these people from 6 into 18. Six is already over by a significant amount.
Mm-hmm. I think that makes sense.
Mm-hmm. So if you took them off of 6, put them in 18 right there.
Right there as well.
Let me come up here and say it.
Okay.
Are we
going
to do that? Are we sure about that?
Yeah, go back out there, because that's affecting me over on 6.
I'm going to save this.
That looks like to me it juts over in 21 worse than it did.
Sure.
That doesn't look as square as it did to me.
And I think it's the way the census blocks are drawn and stuff, too, is kind of the problem there.
Well, one thing it does do for this is, yes, it does jut into 21 here, but it eliminates some of the neck effect that's right here.
Right. Splitting up streets.
Okay. Make it wider entrance.
Yes, it makes a wider entrance into it.
To the cove there.
From here into here.
Are we splitting a neighborhood on that east side, though?
You are splitting some of a neighborhood here.
So the number of houses along the lake there, and you're getting half of
them. But you are splitting a neighborhood over here by leaving it as is.
Yeah.
You're splitting a neighborhood either way.
Either way. But the second change is best for that area.
I guess I have more of a problem splitting a neighborhood where there's only one way in or out, you know, where it's a dead end street, than I do having splitting a neighborhood that goes right out to a main thoroughfare.
So you like that better?
Yeah, it's better because the first one you're splitting a neighborhood with dead end streets.
I don't think it's great either way.
You don't like that right there, Commissioner McAdoo?
That's fine. The second change.
Okay. He's going to make that change, yeah.
Now, this one here, to follow Middle Tennessee Boulevard, instead of the power line,
right.
I recommend changing this.
Pick that up.
No doubt.
Yeah, get you back on Middle Tennessee Boulevard. 13. As the border. Is that the Exxon station?
Actually, I think that's the old, the factory that used to be over here.
Samsonite.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, that far. Okay.
The back there.
Well, that's not true. Corner. I mean, it goes.
Now, y'all want to look down here?
Well, the only thing is, you've got County Farm Road there. If you don't leave County Farm Road there, where you come through and come all the way over to. Come across railroad track and that line back over to 6, and you're going to mess that up.
Right here. So you're coming right now all the way across here, and it's fine.
Well, you turn right here and come around through that old part.
Because those are different subdivisions on either side of County Farm Road.
Yeah, but the future is the future road, correct me if I'm wrong, is to go through there and widen it.
Yes, that's correct.
And connect. So the future road is to connect 41. And 231.
Oh, great.
It's going to be the same way. It's going to come right down County Farm Road.
231 and John Brack.
Yeah.
Joe B. Jackson.
Joe B. Jackson.
Yeah.
You got the end of Joe B. Jackson here. and you got the end of Veterans Parkway that's going to come out here. And something's got to come through here to connect.
It was coming down County Farm Road all the way through.
Yeah.
I didn't worry about that in 2022.
That's exactly right. Get something to do. Probably need to move all of County Farm Road in 18.
I don't agree with that.
Yeah, you could go straight across there because it wasn't 18.
Right, yeah.
You want to see the numbers?
Right.
Yeah, it's not that many. Just go ahead and move. Mm-hmm.
Because those are different subdivisions. When you drive down the farm, it's different on either side of the road.
That's all the old subdivision that runs on across this side, too.
Move it all over there to 18. That looked pretty good.
200.
That brings 6 down to 2.68 and 18 less than 1%.
Yeah.
That's good. That's a good move.
Zap it.
Is that what y'all want?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that's good. Not what I want, but.
Can we back up and look at the whole thing again?
Yes, sir.
That squares up a little bit here, Joe.
All right, I just hold about there just a minute.
Here's looking pretty good. I see how he's standing.
On that?
What do you think? 18?
What does that make 18's numbers?
18 would then be less than 1% over.
What was the point of changing that? What was the point in moving that? We had a boundary line up there, so what?
This one right here, you mean?
Yeah. What was the
compactness, the square limits one.
Where are the city limits?
This is the city limits right here.
So it's following city limits, and it's what you're doing.
And it comes around.
That was one of my objectives when we started, to try to keep some of these city limits, because it just confuses voters.
That part's not in the city right there. That's not in the county.
This is city limits. This is city. This is county.
Yeah. Okay.
But that's urban growth, right?
It is within the city's urban growth boundary.
That is the urban growth boundary.
Mm-hmm. What about the numbers again, Mike? I'm sorry.
With that change or without that change?
Well, yeah, with that change.
With that change, 18 would be 0.6% over. 6 would be 2.68% over, and that brings it down.
That brings yours down, how much it's over.
Well, it's a positive change as far as the numbers are concerned, but I don't know if it looks any better. I don't think it looks any better, and it's outside the city. I mean, I'm not objecting to it, but
I could object to it if you keep talking.
Okay, well, go ahead.
I'm speaking for myself. I don't want to change, but I mean, if a board votes to change it, they'll vote to change it.
I say undo it.
I don't know that we're gaining anything by doing that.
Well, I don't either. There you go. That's what I was trying to say.
Both of them were in within the deviation allowance before we started.
All right. We'll take this part out right there then.
So what you want, Joe? Joe District?
I'd rather leave it be in the 6.
Always have
been. It's still in the county. If it was in the city,
so I'd that is with. Still compact, considered compact or not?
Well, because it's following the
you've got this little city limit thing here, but since it's, if you say you're following the city limits through here, which you're allowed to do, the block right through here does this. And if you look at it,
the city limits.
You reverse this.
But if we say we're going to follow the city limits in one area, do we need to do it in all areas?
No.
But when we can, it's a good idea.
You do it wherever you want.
Only because it's probably impossible.
See this red area here?
Right, yeah.
Which has got 42 people in it. This is a block, believe it or not. Mm-hmm. And as such, it's hard to make anything compact when it looks like that.
C plant.
I just liked it better with the road squared off. It just makes sense to me to be able to drive down one road and say this, especially when you're trying to explain to your constituents where.
Well, and that's what we've done in the other districts as we've been trying to square off so much.
Yeah.
So. reducing, it looks like we're deviating from our plan.
Remaining consistent.
It is all on one, in one district. You drive down that road, but they're both sides.
That's another road right up above where the city is coming from.
See, those neighborhoods connect now, though, up through there.
But you've got a road comes in right, John, right above where that purple is. It comes right out at that red light. They just put in.
That's true.
Right along up there.
Oh, there's your red light, yeah.
That's the road right in yonder, comes out over yonder to red light they just put in. Then this other is County Farm Road right here.
If you follow County Farm Road, that makes it a little bit wider.
County Farm Road comes right there and turns right here and comes around, comes right on and up there.
Yeah.
What's your wishes?
Leave it alone.
Yeah, because County Farm goes down.
Somebody make a motion, we'll just vote.
18, we're looking at 18. What you want to do on 18? Commissioner, it's in your district, 18.
Oh, well.
Are you for it or against it?
I like the circle on the best, but you know.
You like which way the best?
Let it go. If he wants it, you can have it.
I like it like it is, because we voted on 6 earlier like it was, so.
I'd entertain a motion then on 18 if there's no more tweaks.
Go down to, where's the city limits going down Elam Road?
The city limits come down through here like this.
Okay, and see, you put me in the county for 107 people in 13, so I let those city limits out the window.
Yeah. It widens it up
a little bit, right
through here. If you see that, widens it down. Instead of this sticking down so far,
where's he talking about picking up the county?
Right there.
107, 13?
107 is the county nursing home.
That's a county nursing home right there. Mm-hmm.
If you're going on the looks matter theory.
Y'all going to swap a nursing home for County Farm Road? top right hand button. No. That little big round button up there at the top. Right there.
County Farm Road's right here.
Right there.
Right.
You turn right there.
Yeah. Actually, it turns right here.
Yeah, it makes a hard nine.
Yeah, right there. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Like the railroad tracks.
And follows the road right on around through there.
Yeah.
That's a crooked road right there.
You want to swap him out the nursing home for this right here? Swap him out that for that?
Well, we can see what it looks like. I mean,
if you look at the nursing home block, that's it. It comes up here and it follows the river. So it doesn't make things very even through there.
No, can't do that. That looks awful.
Yeah.
Yeah. Committee, we're coming up on our 2-hour limit. I've been aware of, been made aware of. So I would entertain something working on 18, or we're going to move it to next week.
I think we should just move it to next week.
Move
18 to next week. All right. We're going to shuffle that one to next week, let y'all sleep on it, think on it. We have tweaked 1, 5, 10, 11, 12, 9, 3, 19, 16, 14, 15, and 17. So we had a pretty good night, I might say. 12 of them.
Do we need to make a motion for to adopt them as a new map?
I would entertain a motion for those 12 that we worked on tonight to be put into the new, I guess this would be our version 2.
Would ask that you put in there two minor changes I think we did with 17.
We're not going to approve 18 yet. We're just talking about, okay. Yeah, you can go ahead and do the changes in on it, on those two.
This one here?
That we've, yes.
This one here, and
that one.
And
the Middle Tennessee.
This one here.
But we're going to revisit 18 first thing next Wednesday.
First one on the
agenda. First one on the agenda. So y'all two guys, two commissioners get together, and y'all get you a map, take a look at it, and try to work it out for them.
My motion is approve the rest of the changes as made and call this map whatever number we need to call it.
All right. 2.0.
2.0. We have a motion and a second. Second, any questions or discussion on the motion? All those would like to approve, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All that oppose? All right, folks.
Good work.
Next Wednesday here tonight, next Wednesday at 5 again. Is that good?
Yep.
Do we need our county attorney back?
No.
I don't think so neither. So we're not going to ask him to come back. All right. I'd entertain a motion to, we did 12, right? We did 12 of them.
Yes, sir.
We did 12 tonight. Thanks, folks. I think it was a very productive meeting.
Man, that's
my bad. I'd entertain a motion to adjourn.
So
motion and a second. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
We are adjourned. Yeah. Thank you.